120 cars, over $20 million of hardware, 11 countries, 3,000 miles, in just 6 days. This is the craziest rally in the world. This is Gumball 3000. Gumball rocks! From supercars to supermodels.
Amazing, amazing, amazing.
From Hollywood stars to outlandish cars. It's eccentric, glamorous, fast, freaky, and very rock and roll.
And that's it.
It's the greatest adventure you can have on four wheels. It's Gumball 3000.
Capital of the Czech Republic, but more importantly, of course, the start of leg two of the Gumball 3000.
This epic rally has been going for 24 hours and 900 miles since London, and it's already been action-packed.
Thousands of car nuts piled into London to see who was pimped out and pumped up for the start of this mammoth 3,000-mile road trip. And they weren't disappointed. The Star Grid was a mouth-watering collection of supercharged, super-fast, super-pricey hardware.
By the time Formula One ace Jenson Button dropped the flag, the police were fighting back the crowds. So stars like pro skateboarder Rob Dyrdek and trusty bodyguard Big Black escaped from London unscathed.
Armed with energy drinks and sat-navs, the Gumball burned through France, Belgium, Germany and towards the Czech Republic capital, Prague.
800 miles and 9 hours later, first cars arrived. But this isn't a race, it's a rally. And the real fight is for the coveted Spirit of Gumball trophy. That's awarded to the team who make it to the finish in Monaco with the most style, passion and endurance. And in 2005, there's no shortage of contenders.
Being a smart guy, I secured myself a ride in the stretch Hummer. With former getaway driver Big Tony behind the wheel, I was rocking in the back with the Cuban brothers, soul diva Kim Mazel and a fully stocked minibar.
It's the Gumball!
We arrived in Prague 19 hours later, and the partying had taken its toll.
Also struggling to make it through the night was the 1960s VW camper van. Beneath its vintage chassis is a Porsche 911 engine. It may sound like a cool idea, but this baby just keeps overheating. Despite 5 breakdowns on the way to Prague, they didn't give up. That's the spirit.
When Rob Dyrdek and Big Black hit the town, they wanted to party, and they found one on the street. The Czechs were celebrating winning the Ice Hockey World Championships, and Rob and Big Black couldn't resist.
The streets are wild, the streets are rough. We got involved.
But training right at the back, missing all the action and any chance of a decent sleep, was the ice cream van.
Woo!
Under the gaudy exterior lies a standard Ford Transit engine with a top speed of 15 miles per hour and a dodgy oil filter. Forced to make emergency repairs, they've only just made it to the city 2 hours before this morning's start.
Rumour has it that after a short chat with Maximilian, you guys could be in some serious running for the Spirit of Gumball trophy.
Yeah, we'd be so excited about that. Only thing is, if there are any mountains between here and Monaco, we're in trouble because we cannot get up a mountain. It's 5 miles an hour. And we got no ice cream left. All we got is oysters. And these things taste like shit, actually.
Yeah.
They're
horrible.
They're
not wrong. Give it to you. You got to enjoy it when it comes from there.
Now, is it true you've got Dracula on the team?
It's very true, actually. How do you think we get through the nights?
My name is Ottomar Rodolphe Vlad Dracula, Prince Krezulescu, Prince von Canosa.
That's Mr. Dracula to you. What he's saying is he's the last living relative of Vlad the Impaler, better known as Count Dracula. And he's doing the rally with the scariest team of them all, the ice cream van.
We stocked up on all these great things, bubbly, wobbly, and evil clown, Mr. Milk. Could I have a Mr. Milk? Actually, I could use one right now. Unfortunately, we couldn't find a place to plug in the refrigerator, so all our ice cream is melted, and all of our clothes actually are coated with all kinds of milk and cream.
So it's day 2 out of 6, and Gumball is gearing up to leave Prague.
Good morning, one and all.
Mounted, ready to roll.
There's 100 police-patrolled motorway miles between here and the midway pit stop in Vienna, where an awesome crowd awaits.
After lunch, he's off to Gumball Country number 6, Hungary, where the cars go totally nuts at the national Formula One track, the Hungary. It's a chance to really put the hammer down and see what the supercars can do.
By the time Gumball hits Budapest, we'll have another 400 miles under our belts, bringing the overall total to 1,153. As I flew ahead to Prague to see the pack arrive, day two is my first chance to properly experience the rally.
Kind of joined a bit of a team here. These guys all work in the same company together. And they are, I wouldn't say racing each other, but, you know, they're doing it together. It's like a team.
Woo-hoo! Gumball! Yes, folks, Elvis is alive and well, and he's doing Gumball. In true homage to the land of the free, Team Rock is travelling with a Buick Riviera, a Pontiac GTO, and they even have a support Range Rover. Also in Team Rock, there's a hairy Marilyn Monroe and a posse of silver-suited metalheads. For these guys, Gumball literally rocks.
I'm going to love this journey. I'm loving it.
Wait for the boys. Me and the Rock boys are well and truly on our way, but Ed's still in Prague with a stranded ice cream van.
It sounds like they left the lights on last night, so it's a bump start for the ice cream van.
Anyone want to help?
Wish they'd turn the music off.
At last, they're on the road, but with a top speed of 50 miles per hour, they'll be lucky to make Vienna in time for lunch. From big jugs to a big motor, check out this super rare Lamborghini. Yes, you heard right, it's a Lamborghini.
We're up to 65 litres and I'll probably need to put in about another 100. This is a Lamborghini LM002 American. It's a 1992 car. Yeah, I've had it for a couple of years. So it's something a bit different.
This is like driving a supercar strapped to a tank, but it feels good.
Only 301 of these ridiculous machines were ever made. Rob Dyrdek is taking a totally professional approach in his full rally spec Subaru, but some amateur road hogs are getting on his nerves.
Fuck you, you fucking... Fuck your tires, man, you stupid car. Fuck putting your name on the side of your car. Who cares?
Oh, you got your last name on the side of your car.
Oh, that's right.
Man, let's be real here. Dude, would you want any other co-pilot than this man right here? There's no chance on God's green earth I want to risk my life outside of the car with anyone but him.
I got some bad smelling feet, so I go through like 2 pair of socks a day here. You know, I got some of the most gruesome toes you could ever see.
They are made to order. But I want to say 0 to 64 seconds, maybe 400 horsepower, maybe. Safety first is going to be our measure for this particular event. You know, so one, we'll top out at 170. Try to avoid pushing the more dangerous, like 180s and 190.
I can live with that.
We are now cruising, watching some hardcore porno, East Coast style. Straight ugly chicks, but you know, they do good work. They do good work undercover. I recommend this. I give this right now 3.25 stars.
Look at this dude, man.
Dude.
You can't find yourself a better porn looking guy than that.
You got, I'm saying, you got two of the best things in life, high speed and porn. I will tell my stepchildren about this.
Although this is the shortest leg of the rally, Vienna seems a bit too far for my liking. 118 miles till lunch, which seems like a long way when I'm already hungry. But at least we're on our way there. Dracula and co are only just arriving at the Austrian border.
We're here at the checkpoint, or the Austria, right?
They're giving Dracula problems because they don't know what his deal is.
Border check really loosened up when we brought out the gumball booth. Look, they're happy. We gotta go now. They've had enough booze.
In Vienna, the atmosphere is electric as another crowd of petrolheads packs the streets to get a glimpse of the Gumball. They want our photos, our autographs, and they make us feel like superstars.
Watch out! Oh my God! Can you believe it?
Refueled and refreshed, the supercars head to the border. They're happy to hit Hungary and leave the strict Austrian police behind.
There were so many police back there, it is unreal.
700 euro speeding fine.
Really?
Yeah, Dickie's lost his license.
Over the border, it's a blast onto Budapest and the excitement of the Hungaroring. But what of the ice cream van? Well, they've only just arrived in Vienna. Not only are they late, they're lost too.
I think we're in Vienna, but it seems to me that we're lost.
A street name, Heldenplatz.
This is the Rijksstraße.
It's back that way?
Yep.
I think we're on the right track now.
Gumball!
As Dracula arrives in Vienna, the streets are eerily quiet. The crowd's gone home, the food's disappeared, but there is a TV crew on hand to catch an interview with our vampire.
Yeah, I guess there were a lot more people earlier, huh? A lot of the cars, we're actually the last two cars to make it. All right, who wants a cone? The ice cream has melted, but the cone still survives.
Despite all the setbacks, Team Ice Cream press on, but I wouldn't put any money on them catching up with me at the Formula One track. This is the Hungaroring, Hungary's Formula One track, and there's a Formula One crowd here to greet all of the Gumballers that have made it in time for a couple of laps around the track. You're going to go for a break. I'm going to try and schmooze my way into one of the cars. I'll see you in a second. Hungary's the place where the Gumball can let rip. Rumour has it the police are really cool, and besides, there's no speed limit where the Gumball's going now.
This has got to be every petrol head's dream. A sports car and a racing track. No police, no laws, and no limit. It's time to select your vehicle. Which of this year's Gumball lovelies would you choose? Would you go for Max's Ferrari Le Mans? Built for the most grueling endurance race on the planet, it won't fade as the laps pile up. Fancy the out-and-out speed of the fastest production car in the world, the 210 miles per hour Mercedes McLaren SLR. Or perhaps the most expensive car on the rally, the million-dollar Ferrari Enzo.
I appear to have secured myself a ride with the one and only Nods, better known as Paul.
You all right?
I'm really good.
Good.
Now, exactly what is your machine?
360 Spider with F1 gears.
It's a Ferrari. What kind of speed are we going to hit?
I don't know, the straight, apparently they're getting about 140 down the straight, maybe 150 with a push.
Right, come on then, let's get in.
All right, go for it.
Ready for rallying.
I've been a little bit cool about this up until now. This is my first time in a supercar and my first time in a Ferrari. I'm pretty excited.
Excited and scared, Notorious Nods knows no fear, and at 150 miles per hour, this is what a Ferrari sounds like.
That's 100.
hearts in my mouth, my stomach's churning, and I can safely say that was the ride of my life.
We're over 1,000 miles into the rally, and Daryl Hannah's Range Rover is showing signs of wear and tear.
This one's showing metal.
We've busted our tires, two of them. I mean, they're not completely busted yet, but
we curbed it pretty hard.
Me and my rock star buddies haven't made it to Hungary yet. They don't want to miss out on the Hungaroring, and they're picking up the pace. This is Gumball for Real, and it's making me a little bit nervous.
I'm a bit scared right now. I'm not the confident, most confident drivers. I don't actually drive myself. So I'm going to be one of those really annoying backseat passengers. Ada, just slow down a bit, please.
The last thing we need is another hold-up. But hold on, someone's lost their passport.
I'm about to sing a song for this lovely, lovely young Hungarian policeman to let us go because we're missing one passport. But I can't remember any Elvis shoes. Blue suede shoes, remind me of the lyrics, please. I'm not an Elvis.
You can do anything that you want. Wear your blue suede shoes. Don't step.
Okay.
Yes, you're right.
Bye-bye. Pleasure's mine.
I love Hungary.
Thank you. Good luck.
So far, we've had no hassles from the police, but Bentley driver Fraser is convinced they've gone undercover.
Hang on a minute. I bet that's an unmarked car, that Ford's car up there. I bet that's an unmarked group. We'll soon find out. That is. Nah, it's not an unmarked Ford's car.
Certainly safe, Fraser decides to test the water with some dodgy manoeuvres and gets busted.
Well done.
Well, well done. Shut up. How are we doing? Hey, we're skint, you know.
Hello.
Nice policeman.
Yes.
Best mate and all that.
How are you?
Can we go?
Normally, 80 kilometres here, yo.
All right.
80. And you go 100?
Oh, sorry.
47.
147?
Yes.
So
normally your driving license stays in Austria.
So you, do you want to take me a kick, and kick up the butt and we'll call it quits and that? 50.
Okay. Hello.
Hey, this is the best policeman this side of the world. Instead of hitting us for 50, he's hit us for 30.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Hello.
See ya.
The cops tell Fraser to be on his way, but he gets on his bike instead.
What you need to do is get the wee bike out, we'll go for a scoot doing the bike. Hey! Alright, boss. Just wrote the Ferrari off.
Right, let's start playing the game properly now.
Have a nice day.
We've driven 400 miles today, a pretty short hop for the Gumball, but it's been hectic and everyone's stoked to be in stunning Budapest.
Budapest, here we are, finally. We have some, 2 or 3 tickets. He lost his driving license, things like that. Shit happens.
Lost 4 cylinders, picked up a new car, still on it.
We've got the stickers on the way as well. The stickers are going to be here tonight.
So yes.
This will be car number 85 by about 10 o'clock tonight.
And there we have it. Enough said.
The Gumball's put on a hell of a show and brings yet another city to a standstill.
We're here in Budapest. We finally arrived. There's a lot of people. A lot of people. We're very tired. The ice cream truck, we have no idea. It's locked. Could be broken down for all we know. They think I'm a porn star.
Why on earth would they think that?
Dinged our rim up pretty bad and
probably two of our tires are about ready to go.
If you need tires, we got them.
Really?
Yeah, there's a friend of mine. Could we just take a picture? Please?
Always a price.
Come on.
By the time me and Team Rock make it to Budapest, the sun is going down. Elvis doesn't want to be lonesome tonight, so he goes on a chick hunt.
Just short three.
And then you can swap it a little bit
though. Absolutely!
Woo! Absolutely, that one.
From one beautiful historic location to another, this is the world famous Turkish Baths of Budapest, and it's ready to get gumballed.
Yes, but before we take our gowns off and make a splash, let's have a look at what those crazy Cuban brothers have been up to.
Okay, friends, welcome to my crib. This is the Gellert Turkish Bath, the oldest Turkish bath in the whole of Europe, outside of Turkey, of course. The local cheetah's been arriving tonight. Let's go and have a look, come on. Algerio, come on. Everything is after you,
all that you're aware. It's been a wicked couple of days. Much tougher than I ever imagined, and I really need to let my hair down. Hard driving followed by hard partying is what the Gumball's all about. And what a place to party in. Forget about your worries now, we all make mistakes.
At the end of day two, we've nearly 1,200 miles behind us, but we're not even halfway. Tomorrow we'll sort that out. It's a titanic trek across Croatia. The brand new motorways there are empty of cars and cops. A gumballer's dream. Then it's 200 miles down to Dubrovnik, but it's hammer down as there's only one boat out, and if you miss it, it's gumball over. So see you next time on Gumball 3000.